The chief guest of this inaugural function of English Literature Association, a renowned scholar, critic, creative writer, a good friend of mine, Professor Dr. Anand Kulkarni, the guest of honors, former faculties of our department, Honorable P.G. Pandya, who is facing some technical problem to join as he is residing in a remote place of Rajasthan. There is a problem of the fluctuation of the network. He will join with us shortly. And Professor G.S. Zamkhande, sir, the chairperson and head of our institutes, Principal Dr. V.A. Jadhav, sir, departmental faculties, office bearers of English Literature Association 2021-22, and their students. A very good morning to one and all. I, on behalf of my department and the college, would like to extend my warm welcome to one and all here. Friends, with the inception of Shivaji College Udgir, the Department of English has been in existence, that is since June 1968, and celebrated its golden jubilee year just a couple of years back. The Department of English is the largest department of the institution with more than 1,200 students enrolled in present academic year. High result outcomes and active participations of staff in teaching, research, publication, and extracurricular activities. Our department is presently one of the renowned English departments among the institutions affiliated to SRTM University, Nanded. There are 49 books which have plus 170 top world's overseas library holdings and over 70 research papers, book chapters are to create to the department faculties. The department has a tradition of outstanding academic endeavors and active participations of faculties and students in a variety of academic events and activities. Faculty members from the department have actively engaged in a number of national and international conferences, seminars, workshops, like events and other co-curricular events, delivering more than 85 talks on various occasions. So far, 10 scholars have been awarded PhD from the research supervisors of the department. The department faculty has represented on board of studies in English for four consecutive terms. As far as adding the Professor P.G. Pandya's term also, with one term of each nominated syllabus committee and one term on the Senate of the SRTM University. Distinguished MPs, members of the parliaments, MLAs, social workers, educators, international fellows, and so on are among the department's prominent alumni. In recent 5 years, our two students obtained three university top awards in both compulsory as well as optional English. In last 3 years, the department hosted 5 prestigious events with record-breaking responses. One day, university sponsored a workshop on new syllabus with 350 officially registered participants. One two-day university sponsored an international web conference on pandemic literature with 365 registered participants. One national level online essay competition on coronavirus with 69 registered contested participants nationwide. One university level 4-day online invited lecture series for UG students of this university jurisdiction with 1,647 registered participants from SRTM jurisdiction. And recent one, the university sponsored a conference on South Asian studies with plus 200 participants. The English Literature Association is an association, a forum that we form every year since decades when P.G. Pandya and G.S. Zamkhande were on department faculty role. In order to give students a platform to express themselves, till date, many main personalities were invited to inaugurate it, which includes former BUS member and principal of MB College Latur, Dr. M.S. Dadge, Dr. Karkhane, my supervisor, first Fulbright Fellow of this region, and the former Dean Principal Dr. Harihar Kulkarni, Dr. B.L. Jadhav, Dr. L.S. Deshpande, Professor Shailaja Wadikar, Dr. Lokotia, Bhagwan Singh Bias, Dr. Jogdan, Dr. Sidhu Chillurpan Hubli, and Dr. Sangeeta Ghodke, BOS member of the Pune University, and so on. Last year, due to fatal outbreak of COVID pandemic, we could not form military association, and however this year it is being inaugurated virtually by Dr. Anand Kulkarni, renowned scholar, a humanitarian, a name and fame of the Pune University. And our department is privileged today to have Dr. Kulkarni, like outstanding and distinguished personality, to inaugurate it, and Professor Pandey and Jamkhande, like former heads and faculties, who are superannuated decades before and present today, Pandya sir will join shortly to guide and discuss. Now, I would like to invite Mr. P.D. Mane to introduce Dr. Anand Kulkarni, Professor Pandya, Professor Jamkhande, and so on. Please.
Good morning, everybody. Myself, Prashant Mane. I am the faculty from English Department, Shivaji Mahavidyalaya, Udgir. It is the third post of mine. I feel privileged to introduce Dr. Anand Kulkarni sir, P.G. Pandya sir, and Mr. Jamkhande sir. First of all, I would introduce Professor Dr. Anand Bhavanidas Kulkarni sir. I feel privileged to introduce him. I think I can call him the college fellow, as right now three of the alumni of Dayanand Arts College are present in this program. Dr. Kulkarni sir, Dr. Navre sir, and myself, we all belong to the same college. Now in 1992, the journey begins of Kulkarni sir. It is 1992 when he completed his graduation from Mahatma Gandhi Mahavidyalaya, Anpur. From that, 71 kilometers more, in 1994, he completes his post-graduation from Dayanand Arts College, Latur. And then he goes to join Arts, Commerce and Science College, Narayangaon, in 1995. And he completes his PhD in 2005 from Savitribai Phule Pune University. The title of his research was A Study of Realism in Harold Pinter's Plays, with special reference to The Birthday Party, The Caretaker, and The Homecoming. The journey begins from Ahmedpur, goes Latur, and then to Pune, and to, then in Narayangaon. The same is my journey also, but the journey of Anand Kulkarni sir, aage hi aage badhayenge kadam. Meri journey, I came to Shahu College, completed graduation from Shahu College, then went to PG to Dayanand College, then went to Pune, and then came back, laut ke buddhu ghar ko chale, came to Udgir, back, joined as an assistant professor here. Now, he is faculty HOD from Arts, Commerce and Science College, Narayangaon. Under his supervision, 10 of the fellows has completed PhD. He is the supervisor of 10 PhD theses, 5 MPhil dissertations. He has published nearly 15 research papers in peer-reviewed journals, 5 chapters in books. He has completed one major research project also on Indian students and post-structural theories, negotiations and subversions. He edited 5 of the books and authored one book. The title of the book is An Introduction to Literary Theory and Criticism, and it is published by well-known, renowned publishers, Orient Blackson. The same book is prescribed for the syllabus of PG in Savitribai Phule Pune University. He introduced the cultural studies at the PG level in Pune University. He is the Board of Studies member in 2010-15, and from in the second term, he is the Board of Studies member in from 2017. And he conducted online series of talks, Crit Talks, which is called as, and I think he is the fellow who is much more interested in criticism. Now, the second guest of the honor, P.G. Pandya sir, he is the former HOD of my department, which I joined here. I would like to tell you that after P.G. Pandya sir retired from the college, I joined the college. I was working for CHB for 1 year here. And I used to teach the same paper which he used to teach, the literary theory and criticism, for third year. I am honored that we shared the same paper for nearly 3-4 months. P.G. Pandya sir, he was the vice principal of the college. Not only that, but the first cycle in which cycle we got the B+ in NAC accreditation He was the NAC coordinator at the first time. So he completed the first cycle of our college. So we can say that he is the pioneer of the NAC accreditation in our college. Not only that, but he was the BOSper and personally that students who learn under his guidance and tenure, they remember him. Not only they remember him, but they honor him. When he speaks, he doesn't speak, but his whole body speaks. Okay. Some lectures I attended his, and I think his body speaks more than his words. Now, it was the technique and the mastery that he has got on his teaching that which inspires even the guys like me today. The second guest, Mr. Guest of Honor, Mr. Dham Khande, sir, belongs to the same department which I belong to. He is also retired from our college. And sir, I would like to tell you that after you retired from the college from 2013, I am running the cultural department. And the day Dham Khande sir joined from the beginning till the end, Dham Khande sir was the cultural head of the college. And he represented college everywhere. In last 5-6 years, I am the cultural head. I try to do a little bit what I can contribute for the development of the college. Last 5 years, nearly 7 or 8 prizes my team has won in youth festival, and our students have represented in zonal youth festivals also, and in the Dhanushi also, and they have being honored with the prizes in zonal festival also. So this is me introducing Anand Kulkarni sir, PG Pandya sir, and Mr. Dham Khande sir. Thank you, Nawal sir. Over to you, Nawal sir.
Okay, thank you. Now I would like to share one video. The video is prepared only for this event in order to welcome you all people, all dignitaries and the new office bearers of the alien students. And most of the students are not known to the past history of the department. Just I have tried my level best to showcase the history of the department, highlighting the major events we have conducted with 1 minute. Let me share it. Is it visible?
Yes, yes, it is visible, sir.
Okay.
Turn it on, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thanks for watching it. And now it is a turn for the office bearers to put your voices. This year's English Literary Association comprises 9 members, which includes Saraswati Sawant as the president, Smita Gaikwad as the vice president, Shivganga Kendre as a secretary, Atish Mure as a joint secretary, Adinath Mirkale, Pratiksha Nagargoze, Umiriam Beg, Jyoti Joshi, and Pratiksha Kesare, newcomers as a member. I congratulate them, and on behalf of them, I would like to call Umiruman Yusuf Beg to express herself on occasion of this inauguration of their ELA. I will call only 3 to 4 students. And one more thing that I have observed, that two of our former alumni, former students, former presidents of the Literary Association. One is Preeti Holkar, who is from SRDM University, Nanded, and another is Mr. Bhalke, who is a faculty at Haugi Swami College. They joined. It is very difficult to give them a posture to voice because the paucity of the time, but anyone can be given a posture. First, Umiru Man Bey, please.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Good morning to everybody. Respected principal, sir, and the compere of the program, HOD, Dr. A.M. Navle, sir, and the chief guest, Dr. Anand Kulkarni, ACS College of Narayangaon, University of Pune, and the guest of honor, Mr. P.G. Pandya, and Mr. Jia Jamkhande, and the faculty from the English department, Mr. Prashant Mane, sir, and Dr. Gutte, sir, and friends. College is reward for surviving high school. I come from a rural background and my high school in my village. So it was a small town school. Having that background, I can say I survived the high school. So this college is my reward. I was hoping to being a medical student, but couldn't clear NEET, and I take this option for BSc. First day I came, I was literally irritated to myself and thought, ye kahan aa gaye hum? After a 6 month, my opinion is, ye kahan aa gaye hum? This is the success of my college. What I expect from the college, it should assist me on my way. And this college is potent enough to do that. I hope that it would be a reason of my building, of my proper life. What is college for me? The requirement of aspiring the student and the overall development of a balanced society. Every student except from the college first, the best teaching, and second, proper library and the good inculcating activities in the college. The college fulfill all the requirements. I just take this activity and prepare myself for 3 to 4 days for this function. So after having this experience, in future I would never hesitate to deliver a speech in any kind of program. I want to say something about Mane sir. First day I attend first lecture of his, and I impressed by his fluency. The teacher prepare a road ahead. He inspire. He assist to students. This is the quality that student accept from a teacher. Now, I cheerfully thank you to principal sir. He required, he instrumented a good platform for a student and he fulfilled all the requirements. The best teacher are those who show you where to look, but don't tell you what to say. So, in the end, I thank the organizer, the English department. He gave me an opportunity to present myself. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Beck. Now it is turn of Saraswati Sawant from third year, who was present, who was one of the members before the pandemic when we formed the ELA. I think that she was at first year, in first year that time. Please, unmute.
Yes, sir. I am very thank you to everyone for giving me this opportunity to speak. Today's function chief guest, Anand Kulkarni sir, with guest honor, Sri P.G. Pandya sir, Sri G.S. Jam Khande sir, and all my teachers and dear students. I am a student of BATY. I am so glad to be a part of this today function. I am so lucky to have been studying in this beautiful college for the last 3 years now. English department is very good department of Shivaji College. Many workshops are conducted by this department. Each student is given a special guidance to always try to tell the student what the next opportunity for English learning students. All our English teachers pay attention to the studio limit of student. Many program conducted by our English department for student. One of the speciality of our department is that every teacher is master in his subject. The English department has benefited from 3 talented teachers, Master Gupta sir and also Nawle sir. Nawle sir is not only good teacher but also a good author. It is my dignity to be a student of Nawle sir. This event is held every year. Many students attend this event each year, present their wallpapers. Each student is given the opportunity to speak every year. To build confidence. We are very sad for that our grade wallpaper could not be submitted due to online program. Although it was not easy to take online lecture during the lockdown, but English department did it. All English teacher took effort for student during time of lockdown. Our teacher was struggling a lot to cover the syllabus and maintain the flow of study. I thank everyone for giving me opportunity to speak. Thank you, sir.
Now, Pratiksha Kesari. Varun Kasari.
Good morning. I expected Anand sir, Vinayak sir, Arvind sir, teachers, and my dear friends. Myself, Kasali Pratiksha from Shivaji College, Udgir. I am feeling really blessed to share my words on such occasion. And I am proud to say that I am getting this chance because of the English department of my college. This department plays a very vital role in the development of students and their communication skills. It has been working rigorously during the past few years, focusing on the improvement of reading, writing, speaking, and listening skill of students in my college. Students speak and communicate in English. It is also builds confidence in us to interact formally with the people. English Literacy Association has been conducting many varied activity and competition to improve the language skill of the student. And I am very thankful to that. And I am really thankful that it makes comfortable to the student. from villagers and small town like us. Thank you Navli sir to giving me a great opportunity to participate.
Very nice. I appeal Preeti Holkar from SRT University, enable your video. And before that, Pratiksha Nagar Goze, please. Say sir, share your views regarding, because you are totally new to this event. Pratiksha. You should be audible to all of us.
Life is all about the goal, which has to be lived and enjoyed. Good morning, everyone. Respected principal, sir. The program, sir. Chief guest, Dr. Anand Kulkarni, sir, HOD of ACS College, Narayan Gav, University of Pune. Faculty from the English, Dr. Gutte, sir, Professor Pandya, sir, and Jankande, sir, and all my dear friends. The fireworks begin to be. Each diploma is a lighted match. Each one of us is a fire. Good morning. Myself, Pratiksha Nagar Goje, from BSc first year of Shivaji College, begin to express myself in front of you. My father was not a civilian, but he was a part of the force. He completed 26 years in force and now he is retired from it. So, with each transfer, I also kept changing an institute. The last school which I attended was KVIM Joka, Kolkata. I changed nearly 6 schools, out of which 5 were army schools until my matriculation. So you can call me an experienced person. Now, when I remember the first impression of the college at such level of place like Udgir, this stands nowhere. All the schools which I attended were much bigger than this college. The best institute for me until now was APS Bareilly. It was so spacious and luxurious. If I compare this college with all those institutes and colleges, I wasn't satisfied at an initial stage. But I remember, Jindagi Lambi Nahi Badi Honi Chahiye. It's the space that matters, but atmosphere is the space that matters. In this college, he is a clerk in this college. He asked me to come here and told me this is the one of the best college to you. The staff is also best and of its nature. I also like the atmosphere of this college. It is good that I get here. It is native place and it is place for I am habitual to a life of around forces. So I was hoping that like school in college also. There were doing functions and marigold arbor. It's the space of building of life. I aim to join the force by giving serious after graduation. I hope this institute would facilitate me to achieve my aspiration. When I first time come here, I was guided by Manasar. He helps in the problem I face here. He teaches English to us. He is a very good teacher. Because of him, today I get to stand in front of you. He has brought my confidence to high level. He told me very much. He is my mentor. Our principal, sir, is also a very good person. He is very supportive for all the students. He treats all students equally and maintains the discipline in the college. Thanks to our principal, sir, for every effort that he always made in the very direction of improving the education standard of our college. I don't know much about other teachers because I am here, but I have seen that they are very hard workers and great teachers. Today, in front of you, I can proudly say that the teacher told me about this college. In fact, it is much best and college than I had here. Everything is perfect, better than I expected. At last, I want to thank the Ministry for organizing this program and giving me the opportunity expressed myself and shared opinions about this YouTube. I am sure it has given me the first chance to express myself and organize program like essay and others, so on. Provide us last, I want to say that Maki Mamta Barse Chant Sitaro Jesi Hamari College Ki Kirti Bade Sachino Jesi. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.
Okay, wonderful. Now okay, I have muted all of you because some background noise was coming. Preeti, unmute yourself. Yeah. Preeti was, I think that she was the president of Literary Association in probably 2016. Okay. And she wished to share her views, which will inspire the other office bearers, because due to the pandemic, we couldn't conduct these activities last couple of years. And she will share her experiences, what she got from the ELA and what she's doing now. Preeti, please. Only within 1.5 minutes, okay? Or 2 minutes.
Good morning to all guests, teachers, and students. This is Preeti Holkar. I am from Lohara, Taluka Udgir. I have completed my BA with option English from Shivaji College, Udgir. At that time of admission in 2014, I was scared to opt English as an optional subject. As I was considering myself poor in English, my all friends also opt another subject. Everyone, as they were fearful about English. But all the teachers of the department, Dr. Noli sir, Gutte sir, and Mani sir, helped me to pursue to take off English as an optional. We students participate in extracurricular activities, for example, formation of English language association, which includes preparing wallpapers, essays, handwriting, and it is held by Dr. Noli sir. He always tries to encourage us to come forward and speak up. I was selected as the president of ELA, and those small activities helped me to boost confidence and my stage performance. After graduation in Shivaji College, in my subject, I do not have any idea about further education and also looking for near taking admission. But Dr. Nulli sir encouraged me to go to universities for master. And also he talked to my parents. And I came to university and I learned lots of. Now I'm doing MPhil in English literature. I was first rank holder in MPhil CET. That is happened because for my learning activities and guidance of Dr. Noli sir. The teaching learning environment of Shivaji College is very good for all students. I wish to suggest our present and future students, you can do everything in your life, but we have to believe in yourself, and we always respect your teachers and must be honest to yourself. Teachers are our guides, as Dr. Noli sir was mine. You have to find yours. I insist to all the students of Shivaji College to participate in all ELA activities to know the hidden potential in them. I am eager to see our wallpaper entitled Horizon, which was made 3 years before. ELA activities not only open the gates of knowledge, but also developed a leadership of qualities. Thanks to Dr. Noli sir, teacher and principals, for giving me opportunity to express my experience and views about my learning process. I'm also fortunate to see Pradhapak Pandya and Professor Jamkhande, who are true legend for many students. Thank you so much.
Okay, wonderful. Yeah, really, we are missing this wallpaper because due to the online mode of interaction, it was difficult for us to bring it out. But really, these new students of the 2 year, first and second, they are not acquainted with it. Whenever the offline mode will be enabled by the government, surely we will prepare a wonderful wallpaper. And also, one more thing that I will forget to say, that I am planning to organize one innovative e-tour for the Department of English in days to come. New concept which is not carried by any institution till date. If I get the response, I will do it. Okay, our dynamic faculty and IQC coordinator just joined. I welcome him. Dr. Mr. V. M. Pawar. And now I would like to request the honorable guests of the honors. The first one, the former faculty of the department, Professor G. S. Zamkhande, who rendered 3 decades of the service to the department. I request him to talk on this occasion. As it is mentioned by Mr. P. D. Mane, he was the cultural head of our college right from his joining as a lecturer up to his superannuation. It is not a joke to handle a portfolio for 3 decades. Welcome, Professor G.S. Zamkhande, sir, and please share your views. Zamkhande, sir, unmute.
Good morning to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Respected chairman of this function, Dr. Vinayak Jadhav, the chief guest, Dr. Anand Kulkarni, sir, the HOD of our college, Dr. Navle, sir, the ex-HOD of our department, respected P.G. Pandya, sir, all the faculty members of the department, the President Saraswati Sawant of English Literary Association, the office bearers, and friends. It is my great pleasure that after a long period, the department has invited us, myself and my ex-HDO Dr. Pandya, sir. And I feel that I'm in the college campus and with the department, I feel very happy. You know, one more thing is that the chairperson of this function is Dr. Vinayak Jadhav, who is the ex-student of our college. And now he is in the chair as the principal, as well as the chairman of this function. I feel very proud of him. And now I feel that he is my principal because I have joined there in this function. So I feel very happy. I retired 18 years ago. And as Professor Navle mentioned that I was head of the cultural activities for a long time. This activities of English Literary Association actually started when Dr. Navle joined our department. And since then, a lot of activities have been performed, have been arranged, and we feel proud when we listen about all these activities of the department. Actually, such activities enrich the knowledge of the students. You know, I congratulate all the English language literary office bearers. I congratulate English department also. I wish all the best to the activities of the English Literary Association. But we have to, you know, unless and until we work hard, we cannot achieve our goals. I remember 2-3 lines from a poem and I recite that lines. You know, the woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have to promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. So, my dear students, we have to work hard. We have to do so many things. We have to promises to keep and work hard. I wish all the best to all of you. I am very much thankful for inviting me for this function. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Thank you, Zamkhande sir. Very nice to listen you after a gap of more than 1 decade periods. Javier, we are in touch with each other through the phones and the messages. Thank you. Now I would like to request our next guest of honor, Professor P.C. Pandya, to talk, grace the function, guide us, wish us on this occasion. Professor P.C. Pandya served for approximate 36 years in different capacities like faculty, head of the department. He was head of department for more than three decades. NAC coordinator, who was instrumental to fetch B++ grading to the college, as well as the chairman board of studies of English, member of the academic council, editor of the textbook prescribed for the first year and second year, and he superannuated as vice principal of this college decades back. Sir, please, Pandya sir. Unmute, Pandya sir, unmute. Unmute kar. Pandya sir, unmute kara. I am doing here from here. You do from there. Pandya sir, some technical problem he must have faced. He will rejoin. Okay. Yeah.
Good morning. Are you listening to me? Otherwise, okay.
Yeah, you are not visible, sir. You are unmuted, but enable your video. Now talk. Yeah, please.
Honorable Principal Dr. Vinayak Jadhav, Dr. Anand Kulkarni, Professor Jam Khande, Dr. Arvind Navle, faculty of the college, office bearers of English Literary Association, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning to everybody. I am Pandya. I'm talking to you after a long time. At the very outset, I would like to congratulate all the office bearers of English Literary Association and extend my best wishes to them. I know that the association will provide them opportunities to explore themselves and help them to articulate their feelings, ideas, and thoughts. It will certainly boost their creativity. They will write poems, write articles on different subjects, and do all literary activities that will mold their personalities in a way. It's also a matter of immense pleasure for me to share this platform with you all on the occasion of this inaugural function of this ELA. And I wish that in due course of time, the students will develop different skills related with literary matters, and that will help also to develop their personality. It's a matter of immense pleasure to share this platform with you. Actually, our times were totally different when there were no virtual conferences or virtual meetings like we are doing today, because a technology has done great progress during these periods. Actually, COVID-19 has, this pandemic has totally changed our lifestyle, and we are far away and yet closed on this platform. I take this opportunity also to congratulate Dr. Arvind Navle, who has very successfully completed and very gloriously completed 25 years of service. Dr. Navle has been a close colleague and has my personal relationship with him as a friend. And I have tried to do my best to help him whenever I could do it during the times when he was appointed as a lecturer in my college. he has made great progress during these 25 years and wrote many books. He has edited many critical books also. This goes to his credit. I have many things to say, but on this platform, I have lost these 17 and 18 years living in a rural premises. Actually, I'm living at the place as a recluse, totally cut off from all activities otherwise. On this occasion, once again, I wish this literary association great success, and these boys will continue to develop themselves, personality will develop. I wish you all best of luck. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pandya sir. Thanks for your blessing and wishes. I welcome Dr. Aryam Manzare, who recently joined and was enabled in video. You can enable. You are one of the authorities of the college, Manzare sir and VM Pawar. Now, it is a turn to invite Honorable Chief Guest, the inaugural guest for his inaugural speech. And that's why now I would like to request Professor Anand Kulkarni to virtually inaugurate formation of our ALA and deliver your inaugural speech. Professor Anand, please.
Hello and very good morning to all of you. At the very outset, I declare that the English Literary Association is inaugurated. I have very mixed response right now. There are reasons for that. I shall come to these responses afterwards. But as a token of formality, as a matter of formality, I should start with the special mention of the dignitaries for this virtual meeting. Respected Dr. Jadhav sir, principal of Shivaji College, Udgir. Two very senior academicians and ex-faculty members of Department of English. Respected Dr. Pandya sir and Dr. Jamkindekar sir. And all other respected colleagues of the Department of English, the office bearers of English Literary Association, students and all those who are interested in other faculty members as well. And of course, my very close friend, my classmate, Dr. Arvind Nawle, who is also head of the department and who has convened this virtual meeting. I take this as an opportunity to interact with you informally, because this is the college which has stood all the difficulties and adversities and has come out with flying colors for the last so many years, Shivaji College of Kir. It was on the kind suggestion of my friend, Dr. Arvind, that I went through, I browsed through the college website and I was impressed by the kind of work that the college has done so far. All the respected members of your management, Honorable Principal and all his colleagues and faculty members have done great service to the society and have made scintillating progress as far as the academic things are concerned. Also, the education that you have been giving to students coming from masses. I'm very happy that I am a part of this kind of program where students are encouraged to speak, students are brought to the front. These are the signs where you shall see real teacher works behind. And Dr. Arvind and his colleagues have been doing a human service to the entire student community. One more thing of which I was very much impressed, and I would rather call it to be a very stunning kind of discovery for me is that the Department of English, because I was more interested in browsing through the Department of English, that the department has given some of the finest ex-students to the society who have gone to risen to different prestigious positions in the society and have been contributing in different fields. Some of them have risen to very great positions indeed. Some of them have been very good teachers as well. So the alumni of the department, the present faculty of the department, and also that the department runs UG to PG and even PhD courses for students. It's something I think very uncommon these days. Uncommon for the very reason that there is a lack or absence of, and sadly it is so, that there is a lack or absence of commitment and involvement and passion. And I bet on this that Dr. Arvind is both committed, involved, passionate. He's more passionate about these kinds of activities, you know. I think someone, Manesar perhaps, must he mentioned that we all belong to the Dayanand College of Arts, Latur. Thankfully, I was also a classmate of Dr. Arvind. I had experienced him. He was quite active and dynamic, even as a student. Even those days, we could wonder as to how he could take the charge of so many activities that could be carried out in the name of culture, in the name of academic activities of the department and all that. In a way, he was a leader for us, and he has continued to be a leader for so many years. I am so happy that he still holds the position, you know. He is still our leader in many ways, of course. And I have great respect for him for the very simple reason that he has not let down. His spirit continues. He has contributed immensely, has written so many books, has been the member of Board of Studies, has acted in different capacities, both in college, outside college. All those things have been there, you know. So I'm all praise for him, obviously, both being my friend and I don't think this is the only justification for his praise, but there are several reasons for that. So great laurels to you, Dr. Arvind, and to your college as well, for having done such spectacular progress for the last so many years. Another thing which came as a pleasant surprise to me was this, right now, that two ex-members, faculty members of the department were cordially invited, and they were requested to talk on this occasion. This is where I think we have to continue with this Guru Shishya Parampara, I believe. And I believe that this is a sign of a very good tradition and legacy that your department has maintained so far. Thanks, of course, to Dr. Pandya, sir, for having set the tone of such glorious traditions. And thanks are also due to Dr. Navale, sir, for having continued stoplessly, ceaselessly, this kind of tradition. These are very rare things. I have attended so many conferences and these kinds of programs, but I could hardly see the ex-faculties coming onto the floor and sharing their views. Also, I am surprised, and of course, pleasantly surprised, to see students being promoted, students being asked to talk. These are the occasions when students should be promoted, should be encouraged, because they need to have necessary courage and necessary boldness, you know, the confidence, so that they would come out with their own expressions. Well, students, brothers and sisters, we too also started our journey from remote places. We also did not have much of the infrastructure. We started from very ordinary background. There was nothing which was very good with us. But then I think because things are not favorable to us does not mean that we should not work hard. We should. adversities actually invite us to perform better. That is what I think the lesson that we have learned so far for last so many years. And I'm sure if we have any significant role to play as teachers, it is this, that we have to share this, these lessons of life, that things come and go, that the shadows will not last for longer, that things will change positively. The only thing that we have to do is to maintain confidence. And probably the most iconic and scintillating example of such kind of confidence is Dr. Navle, for the reason that Dr. Navle suffered a tragic experience, as we all know, because of the COVID-19 pandemic and all those things. Still, he rose like a phoenix and has come to this level of performance, you know. I have great regard for him, and now not respect, you know, great regard for him for this very reason, for having shown this kind of courage and bravery to set aside the personal losses that he has suffered, very unfortunately, and has come out to this level of performance. You know, kudos to him for having done all this. This is very difficult, brothers and sisters, performing in such kinds of conditions when you have this. These are all very traumatic experiences. We have been passing through very tragic situations. This is a testing time, and we have to maintain our confidence, maintain the positivity, the positive mindset, and all those things. Dr. Arvind is a very ideal example for all this again. So I have special affinities with him for these reasons, of course. I should not have mentioned these things in this program, but I felt like doing that because, you know, we have been teaching and learning literature for so many years. So what is literature if it is not this? What is literature if it doesn't teach us how to stand above the water, how to show ourselves to the society, and how to withstand the blows that are given to us, unfortunately, by the conditions, unfavorable conditions. We have to stand on our own in the unfortunate and unfavorable conditions. Let us change unfavorable to favorable, and let us turn towards the expression of the best in us. That was what Swami Vivekananda had said. We celebrated his birth centenary, you know, a couple of days back. So education is always meant for drawing the best out of us. Literature is also meant for drawing the best possible within us. There are so many emotions and feelings, because literature is all about feelings and emotions. Let me tell you, it is not a craft, just it is an art. Literature is an art. It is not a craft, simply. That it is not about the structure. It is about the way the structures are organized, the way the emotions are expressed, the ways the feelings are felt, the ways the ideas are expressed. Isn't it? So it's a kind of interaction between those who write and those who read. But this is like kind of thing, you know, that there is a kind of transfer of these feelings and ideas from those who feel them, express them, and later on being read by readers. Some of you might have heard sometime that, and I still even consider these to be very important kind of views about literature. There was someone called Thomas Dick Vancey who came out with the proposition of the two of the finest divisions of literature. One was literature of knowledge, another was literature of ideas. This literature of knowledge is something which moves us, which gives us knowledge. Literature of power is something which moves us. So literature not only gives us knowledge, it also moves us. And I think the second part is more important, because some of you must have been reading these days, and if you are not, you must, because we are in the age of technology, and that on a single click, things are available to us. You can just browse through And you will understand that many more Indian writers have been writing these days, coming out with their own expressions, as if there is a kind of democratization of writing, that there is a kind of opening up of all kinds of expressions, which will give you the idea that there is freshness, there is originality in the expression of these writers, and also that they are very honest to what they write. What is important is this, that we have to be honest in what we write or read. Fine. So my kind advice to you students will be this, that you kindly read, because these days we have forgotten, these days we have learned how to see, you know, the visual supremacy has been much power with us. We see the things, we do not listen, we do not think, we do not speak, we simply see. And we don't want to simply see, we want to think and speak as well. For thinking and speaking, reading is important. The more you read, the more you can think better. The more you can think better, the more the better you can behave in the society and can make a substantial contribution to the society as ideal citizen. This is, I think, very important. If you are students of literature and language, these two things that you have to keep in mind, that please read and continue to write. Whatever comes to your mind, you know, do not hesitate writing. Do not feel shy. Mostly, we feel shy and we feel inconfident in writing in English. Don't do that, because your practice of writing will give you the necessary confidence and later on the necessary expertise that you need to write in much more sophisticated and refined and effective form. The other thing that I would like to share with you is that literature has to give us two things. Literature educates us. Do not you think? If you, I shall take you back to Hamlet's, Shakespeare's plays, you know, because that I think is the safer thing to do right now. You will understand if you go through the plays by Shakespeare, that Shakespeare teaches us in many ways. And one of the lessons is that we should not be suspicious unnecessarily unless our suspicion is very well grounded and verified. This is Othello. Then you turn towards Macbeth and you will understand that there is something called ambition. There is no harm in being ambitious, but there is a lot of harm in being overambitious. That you want to be a king, that is fine. Each one of us has ambitions, you know. All of us, we would like to be ambitious and we would like to progress. And we are not happy with what is given to us. We want to be something very different, someone very different. And it is nothing unnatural. What is unnatural is, what is uncommon is, and in a way, towards the end, what is disastrous is this, that we should not be over-ambitious. That is how it educates us. This is Macbeth, you know. You turn towards Hamlet and you will understand that all of us probably do not think. Many of us do not think. Many of us do not act. Many of us either act or think. What happens if we only think and do not act? Hamlet. What happens when we only act and do not think? Macbeth. This is, put in very simple words, you shall see, Shakespeare was trying to educate us. Now, I took the example, the historical name of Shakespeare. But Shakespeare is not the only one example, you know. There have been so many writers in English literature across different literatures in the world, where you will understand that the writers have tried to share their insights into life. And these insights are nothing but the lessons given to us in our morality, in ethics, in honesty, in loyalty. As if these are the teachings, you know. So literature educates us. Literature refines the basiness, the meaningness. It makes us what we are right now. Another thing that literature does is that literature gives us pleasure. Literature delights us. These are the two important functions outlined by Mr. S.T. Coleridge, that literature has to educate and delight, instruct and delight. What kind of pleasure do we get? My love is like a red, red rose. My love is like a red, red rose that is newly sprung in June. You remember Robert Burns? Now, how do you interpret this? My simple suggestion will be, please do not interpret, please enjoy. Literature is meant for enjoyment, you know. None of us would be able to teach. Literature is not something which you can teach. I am sure Dr. Arvind will agree with me that it is by the turning of 50 around, 50 years of our age, that we have slowly started realizing the sweetness of literature, isn't it? How literature is sweet. And it is only after having gone through several difficulties, several adversities, several examples which are nightmarish, that we have come to know that it is literature which finally works as a solace to all of us. That is what you shall see. Literature is all the more meant for this. It gives us delight. It is like a flower that is newly bloomed, you know. It is like leaves coming to the tree. It is as natural, as fresh, as beautiful, as pleasant, and as lovable, you know. You have a bunch of flowers, a basket full of flowers. When you come to most kinds or types of literature, you will realize, not just drama and poetry, turn towards novel, turn towards short stories and science fiction, and these days blogs also, and you will understand that literature has been doing a huge service to the society in refining them, in making them, keeping them human. If you ask me what role literature has to play in 21st century, because we are in 2022, you know, what literature has to do with us? Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, literature has this huge historical role of keeping us human. That is it, you know. We need to be human. And for by human, I do not simply mean walking on our two legs and thinking and seeing, you know, but also interacting, maintaining relations. And being human means sharing love. That is what literature has to do, you know. You go to any other form of expression and you will find that those forms are not as delightful, as pleasant, as colorful, as insightful, as varied as literature is. You go, for example, music, go for painting, go for any other art form, and you will realize what I am saying. Mr. Plato was wrong in many ways, if you remember, who charged poetry unnecessarily for several reasons. But then look at how the history took revenge on Mr. Plato. His disciple, the famous great, another famous great Greek philosopher, Mr. Aristotle, came out with a strong and well-reasoned defense of literature in general, you know, and art in particular, of course. So you shall see that art has been, all forms of art have been the constant source of inspiration and delight to all human beings. Literature has, of course, been at the forefront. It has been the front runner, because literature is obvious, because literature is something which comes in the verbal form, because language is its medium of expression, and because language is something which we use quite often. Do not you think? Say, for example, if I say, I want to meet you, and if I say, Jethe Sagara Dharani Milte Tithe Tujhimi Vata Pahate, kind of thing. Look at the rhythm that is created out of it. Look at the beauty that is created out of it. You shall see that there have been, for example, there are some of the finest lines in Marathi, and I'm sorry I'm referring to Marathi, because I strongly believe that language is not at all a barrier, and we should come to that. Kaad sakhe tujhe galatil chandane jihad is the kind of thing, you know. This was Kusumagraj writing. Now, what do you think? Isn't it a kind of combination of beauty, anxiety at the same time, delight that the poet would like to share with? This why kar sake tujhe gadatil chandanyache. This chandanyache hath is the kind of phrase that makes it so beautifully poetic. You know, the drabness, the stupidity, the drabness, the unpoeticness, you know, the practicality are taken care of. Everything is removed, and what remains over there is the sheer pleasure, the sheer ecstasy that you have. This is what I mean by sheer ecstasy, you know. For example, heard melodies are sweet, but those unheard are still sweeter kind of thing, you know. Now this unheard, why unheard melodies are still sweeter? That is where literature comes, I think. That is where poetry comes. That is where all forms of literature comes. Because all forms of literature take us to the places which are even invisible, but the places which are deeply embedded within our mind. It takes us to the different corners, the different recesses of our mind. You know, it explores the possibilities of being beautiful, of being happy, and being true and permanent. That is what Keats wanted to be. John Keats, the famous romantic poet, wanted to be immortal. Unfortunately, died at the age of 26, died of tuberculosis and all that. We all know how tragic it was, because he was considered afterwards to be the next Shakespeare of English poetry, English literature. But then, how could he immortalize himself? Writing some of the finest lines, you know. Even today we read them and we feel the same pleasure with the similar intensity that it must have been written some 200 years back. That is where literature has this role of making the things immortal. What about you and me? We are today, we may not be tomorrow. Things go on, you know. Nothing is permanent over here. Our bodies are not permanent. Our minds are not permanent. What is permanent is art. What is permanent is literature. So this permanence, the search for the pursuit of permanence, it's something which lands into literature, you know. The literature is important because it keeps us human, because it educates us, because it delights us, because it explores the possibilities of being happy and beautiful, because it immortalizes us, because it expresses our strong desire to be immortal. None of us would like to die, you know. Who one of us would like to die? We would like to live forever. But can we do that? We have our own limitations, you know. Art doesn't have its limitations, and it is through art that life expresses. The flow of life continues, you know. As I earlier said, we are today, we may not be, but the life goes on. And this continuity of life is something that literature is responsible for. Literature expresses, reflects the continuity of life, the pleasure of life. That is it. Arvind, I hope I am not running out of time.
No, no, there is no time limit. Okay, carry on.
No, fine. But then
Anand, you are talking in such a way that so spontaneously as a flower exhales fragrance. So beautifully, so spontaneously, you are talking and the words are coming from your vocal cord as a flower exhales fragrance. Carry on.
Oh, thank you. Are khub divsani itki changli mahfil tujhyamule जमली मला इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ होम कमिंग यू नो फॉर मी आय कॅन सी सम ऑफ द नोन फेसेस एज इफ आय एम इन उदगीर अँड आय एम व्हेरी हॅपी यू नो दॅट एलिमेंट ऑफ होम कमिंग इज ऑलवेज देअर यू नो एस्पेशली फॉर दोज हू हॅव माइग्रेटेड फ्रॉम देअर नेटिव प्लेसेस टू प्लेसेस लाइक पुणे आय फील दॅट अर्ज या थँक्स एनीवे So I shall take a couple of other examples and then thank you. And then we shall wind up. I cannot stop referring to two of the finest examples. One, of course, by Samuel Beckett. He is my very favorite writer, a poet par excellence. You know why he wrote the plays he wrote. We have two other very important writers before Beckett. One was Henrik Ibsen, a very famous Norwegian playwright, dramatist. And the other one, of course, George Bernard Shaw. And Shaw was responsible for making drama realistic. Now, you know, these were the writers, Ibsen and Shaw were the writers who were trying to provide solutions to the problems of society. This is one more role you shall see literature always plays. Literature brings the problems to the forefront. Literature makes the problems noticeable to the people, you know. Otherwise, how can we understand that these are the problems? Otherwise, how can we understand? Say, for example, while I refer to Ibsen, I have in my mind Vijay Tendulkar in Marathi, you shall see. Tendulkar wrote some of the finest plays in Marathi. And what Tendulkar was doing was Tendulkar was trying to bring to the surface the violence within us. The violence that is always suppressed within us, you know. The unethical practices that we are interested in, the hypocrisy that we are going on, you know. So, Ibsen and literature has this role, you know, of bringing all the social maladies to the forefront, make them noticeable, and these kinds of realizations practically help human beings to overcome them. So literature has this purification role as well. Literature refines and purifies us. That was what Aristotle had said some 200 years back, 2000 years back, that tragedy has this role, cathartic role of purifying and purgating us, you know. So I think there is a kind of refinement that literature has to play. Well, I refer to Ibsen and Shaw because Ibsen and Shaw were trying to give the touch of modernity to drama. They were bringing all kinds of experiments to writing of plays. But what makes Beckett more different, more distinctive, uniquely operating, is this, that there is something called an absolute absence of values. Now imagine you are writing against the background of the First World War, the Second World War. You are writing against the background when you have realized that there is nothing that is sure in our life, that there is nothing certain, that there are no exact values, that there is nothing that sustains us, that there is nothing sure in our life. So there is no guarantee of anything whatsoever. It is against this fragmentation, against this brokenness, you know, or against this disintegrated human life that he was writing. Another, that he was writing as a Jew, and he was a migrated writer again. Now, you write about the absence of values, absence of certainties, and then you have to write. Now, these are the two things that we have to understand. There is a compulsion to write, and that you have to write compulsorily what is not to be written. This is something which is very unique, you know. There is a kind of coalescing, a kind of combination between these two. There is nothing that is substantial that you can write, you know, substantial that you can share. You have nothing substantial to share. And of course, when there have been two world wars, and that you have lost everything, and that you have lost your belief, your trust in all kinds of institutions, you know, Albert Camus was doing elsewhere this kind of thing. That there was something called absurdity, which was very much in vogue. It was very much prevalent. Life has turned out to be absolutely absurd. So this absurdity is something which became the substance. आता तुम्ही बघा, how nirarthakta can be the subject of expression. You have something to say, you know, so you can say something. But there was nothing left to say. Now, if there is nothing left to say, then the only thing that you can do is to show. And that is what Beckett does. He shows two of the triumphs coming together. You know, in Waiting for Godot, for example, Vladimir and Estragon, and look at the kind of interaction between them. And you will realize that they are interacting in the words which are decidedly and purposefully incoherent. What they speak to each other is not at all meaningful, not at all dialogic. There is no communication. There is an absolute loss of intelligibility. We do not understand anything. Now, what do you think? What is all this? Has life turned to this stage, you know, where we have lost everything? Now, you can raise these kinds of questions. I refer to Beckett because I want you to understand that literature continues to experiment itself. From Shakespeare down to Beckett, from Beckett down to Brecht, you know, from Brecht down to Tom Stoppard. You have so many of them. Even in India, you have some of the finest playwrights. Unfortunately, India could not produce the best playwrights like Girish Karnad or Tendulkar or Badal Sarkar afterwards. Mahesh Dattan is doing his best, but that is the only name that can be taken right now. We have so many very good novelists, very good poets as well. And despite the fact that India has a glorious tradition of writing plays, you know, both the elite plays and the non-elite plays, still we have not been able to come out with some of the finest playwrights today in the present context. But then you shall see that drama has this role of not just bringing the things to our notice, making them poignant, making them so strong and piercing, you know, that they enter into our mind and we start thinking over. Literature has this role of thinking over, you know. Two triumphs on the stage, talking to each other, talking nonsense. What do you think? What kind of sense you and I have to make as audience? No sense at all. There is an absolute nonsense. So this nonsense is performed on the stage and we are asked to make the sense of them. Now, this is something which is ridiculous, apparently, but this is what we have been doing for last so many years, isn't it? We have been doing something which we are not supposed to do, and we are not doing something which we are supposed to do. There is some kind of mismatch. Literature has this role of bringing this mismatch to the notice of the society. That is why he wrote, Brecht wrote the other way. He came out with the alienation effect, you know, that audiences were given the impression that they were the part of the drama, that you are watching a play and that you are also the part of the play, or something that he was experimenting with. But then where literature becomes such a beautiful expression probably is poetry. It is in poetry, you know. It is in the writing of some of the finest poems that you will find. For example, you go through, I am a diehard fan of the romantic poetry. Most of the Indians have been, so I am also. That if you go through some of the finest poems by P.B. Shelley, by Wordsworth, by Coleridge, any of them, and you will understand the beauty of expression. This beauty of expression makes him happy. So my simple suggestion to you will be, this is not advice, because we have still miles to go before we slip, you know. That was Frost saying it. But then you have so many miles to go, more than what we have done so far. You shall see, you have a bright future. English literature will help you in times of crisis. I am sure Dr. Arvind could recover from the serious shocks only probably because of this inexorable source of literature. He being a student of literature, probably, and a very good researcher and academician, could recover so early and so powerfully. Otherwise, this is all very difficult, you shall see. Literature has this potential of providing the necessary power to all of us. It is as if a tablet, a medicine with no side effects at all. Literature is a medicine with no side effects at all. The only effects that the early rising sun, which gives you all the necessary strength and positivity to enjoy and live life. Thanks to all of you for having listened to me so patiently. And I'm sure these kinds of occasions would probably provide you the necessary impetus and confidence, especially for students. I am very much delighted, Dr. Arvind, for students, you know, you promote and encourage your students to actively participate into these kinds of activities. That is the mark of a very good teacher. You know, you have been doing it. Even in your student days also, you used to cooperate and help. Many of us, of course, not just me, you know, many of our classmates, I still remember, you have been such a source of, each time we remember you, not just me, many of our classmates, we remember the positive, dynamic, active, very fresh kind of Arvind, who gives us all the necessary energy and strength to live life in the midst of all kinds of difficulties and adversities. So your department is fortunate enough. You have some of the finest teachers over here. You know, I went through your department profile and it is so strong, you know, that you have come out with such books and research activities. You have been doing a lot of academic activities. You have such ex-faculty members like Dr. Pandya and Professor Damkhandi, sir. They have set the tone, they have laid the foundations, and Dr. Navle and his team, Professor Mane and others, have been doing very good service to the college, not only to the college, to students as well. With one more mention, one of the students spoke that she comes from a very rural place, you know, from where she does not have any access to English or anything of that sort. That is where I think the Department of English has been working so far. Your Department of English has been providing opportunities to those who are deprived of opportunities. That is what education is all meant for. Your department is something of this kind of value and significance, you know, that it has been bringing knowledge to students at their doorsteps. What else we want, you know? Thanks to you. Thanks to all dear students. I am sure you will do the best in your future. Pandemic will pass by and we shall regain our strength. We'll come out with all the necessary expectations and desires. My best wishes to you all, to Dr. Navle and his team, to Honorable Principal and other two respected teachers on the dais, Dr. Pandya sir and Professor Damkandi sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Anand. Proud of you. Very wonderfully, you've delivered your speech and you emphasized on the values of the literature and the new generation, new breed of the teachers. They must learn a lot from your talk, how to fight toward our jobs, how to fight toward humanity, and to remain at least minimum basic qualities of human beings. And if we are teacher of the literature and language, and we don't possess these things, it is useless, obviously and absolutely. Wonderfully, you touched almost all the issues, and the founding teachers too must have enjoyed it, students as well as all the participants. Really mind-blowing your speech was, and I am acquainted with you when you first delivered one seminar on the Othello when we were classmates, presidential address of Principal Dr. V.A. Jadhav sir, and addressed this gathering. Dr.
Good morning, sir. Good morning to you one and all, sir. Distinguished chief guest for today's inaugural function, Dr. Anand Kulkarni sir, professor and head Department of English, ACS College in Narayangaon, district Pune. I am privileged to have former HOD and faculties who taught me to in my college days, my gurus, Professor Pandya sir and Professor Jamkhande sir, in our panel as a respected guest of honor, coordinator of this function, Dr. Arvind Navle, HOD, Department of English, other faculties, and my dear friends. At the outset, I thank Dr. Anand Kulkarni sir, Professor P.G. Pandya sir, and Professor G.S. Jamkhande sir, who got associated with our esteemed concern, quality education, for the advancement of masses. It is a legacy and a heritage that Dr. Navle is carrying forward, pioneered by Professor Pandya sir, Professor Jamkhande sir, and other precursors, being the former HOD and faculties of the English department. I want to say about Kulkarni sir and about Mr. Navle sir, the faithful man pursues nothing less than opportunity in difficulties. We all know that English is an internationally official language which opens the door of the world. So I expect more hard work from English Literary Association and English faculties for the improvement of reading, writing, speaking, and listening skills of the students in English, so that each and every student speaks and communicate through English. No doubt, it is a Herculean task, but we can do it by conducting many varied activities and competition. We will improve the language skills of the student. We know practice makes a man perfect. As the opinion expressed by the student, such activities like English Literary Association would surely help to assist in intellectual and psychological enhancement of the students. The values of such programs inculcate have no match to other channels. Right. As the opinion expressed by few students that few difficulties they face. Sir, number of participants attending this program are from rural areas. Number of difficulties were there in taking education. But as Kulkarni sir pointed out that every difficulty is an opportunity for personal growth. And victory comes from finding opportunities in problems. We strive for the excellence, the natural and psychological development of the student. It is better to invent and innovate new mechanisms in the current changing scenarios. I am here watching the program since beginning. I am highly impressed by the talk delivered by the chief guest, Dr. Anand Kulkarni sir. The involvement, views and wishes of Professor Pandya sir, Professor Jamkhande sir, and even the small talks of departmental students, Beg, Savan, Kasare, Nagargoje, Priti, etc., as well as the videos showcasing the whole history of English department and its activities and achievements since its inception, that is from 1968 to till date. It is mind-blowing, super, and inspiring to rest one and all. I congratulate and appreciate Dr. Nawle because of him only, after a long period, I met my both the gurus, Dr. Pandya sir and Dr. Zamte sir. Wish all the best to the department to excel in every walk and step in coming days and years to come. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
I would like to propose the vote of thanks. I'm thankful to one and all, special to Professor Anand Kulkarni, Professor Pandya sir, Professor Jamkhande sir, Chairperson Principal V.A. Jadhav sir, faculties, two vice principal who were joined visibly, as they also must know, they also know that this is the function of students. Okay, and we have given more priority today to the students, and above all, I am thankful to office bearers of the ELA and rest students for their presence here and for making this event grand success. Now I am screening the national anthem. Please stand. Thank you. You may sit at your places. Thank you.